Morning class. So yesterday what we have done questions of increasing, decreasing. Today also we will do some questions of increasing and decreasing. Now just see on the board if the question is prove that y is equal to 4 sine theta upon 2 plus cos theta minus theta is an increasing function in the domain in the closed interval. Just see it is a closed interval 0 to pi by 2. Yeah. Now what we have to do, we have to prove that it is increasing function. It is not given strictly increasing, strictly decreasing or decreasing, nothing. They are just asking increasing. But for that also we have to find things. So just see, first of all, the first step, every time what we are having, just get the differentiation of this particular function. So what you are having, y is equal to this function, so y dash will be equal to what? This is what? A, you are having denominator. So, you can apply in this function cos theta whole square. Then, differentiation of numerator, that will be 4 cos sin theta will be 4 as it is. Sin theta differentiation will be cos theta into denominator as it is 2 plus cos theta. Then, minus the numerator as it is 4 sin theta. Multiplied by the differentiation of denominator. What is denominator? 2 plus cos theta. So 2 is what? Constant. So 0 cos theta will be minus sin. Differentiation of cos theta will be minus sin theta. I will not consider 0. There is no need. Anshuman, please be on time. Yeah. So this is a function. Now y dash will be equal to what? Y dash will be equal to 2 plus cos theta whole square, and here we open it up. 4 to the 8. 8 cos theta, 4 cos theta into cos theta plus 4 cos square theta minus. Now just see, this is minus, this is minus, minus is minus plus 4 times sine square theta. Anshuman, Akshita, please be on time. I don't know why you people are coming so late. Anshuman, Akshita, and all of you, please be on time. If you want to attend the class at 9:25, at least you should enter the class. Yeah? Again, I'm telling you, we are having a question that y is equal to sin theta upon 2 plus cos theta minus theta as an increasing function. In this particular domain, we have to find. So, first step, every time, what is our first step? To find. Wait a minute, this is Yama. Wait for. In the increasing function in the closed interval 0 to pi. So first of all, what we have to do, if we should find y dash. Now y dash will be equal to what? This is again a question. We can apply this function. We have applied. Now minus theta is also there. So minus theta is also there. Now how you will differentiate dy by dx or dy by d theta? You will differentiate it with respect to theta. Why? Because the function is not in x. It is not sine x. Plus cos x. It is in the terms of theta. I have written y dash. Y dash is equal to what? Y dash is dy by d theta. There is, don't get confused. Don't write dy by dx. That is, then it will be wrong. Because the function is in theta, so we are differentiating with respect to theta. Yeah. Now this minus 1 will be there. Yeah. So again, what we will do? Minus 1, this denominator, we can take where I take the LCM. So it will be minus 9. 2 plus cos theta. Yeah, that here theta differentiation will be what? Theta will be 1, like differentiation of x is what? 1 only. Yeah, then what do we get? Just see these two terms, 4 cos square theta plus 4 sin square theta. 4 times cos square theta plus sin square theta. If we write this cos square theta, sin square theta, we know that is what? 1. This whole quantity will become what? 1. And this also we can open here only. This is 2 plus cos theta whole square. So can we open it here only? Yes, because we are having this of space. So open 2 plus cos theta whole square here only. It will be 4 plus will be a square plus b square cos square theta plus 4 cos. That clear? Here, now just see what we are going to do. Reducible, yes. So just see 8 cos theta as it is. 8 cos theta as it is. 4 cos square theta plus 4 sin square theta I told you take 4 common cos square theta plus sin square theta will be 1. So it will be what? Plus 4 minus, open this bracket, minus 4 minus cos square theta minus 4 cos theta upon the same quantity 2 plus cos theta. Okay, is it clear? Now what we are going to get is plus 4 will get cancelled with minus 4. Clear? This 8 cos theta minus 4 cos theta will be what? 4 cos theta minus cos square theta upon 2 plus cos theta. This you have got as what? This you have got 4 cos theta minus cos square theta upon 2 plus cos theta whole square is your y dash. So if you want to write y dash, please write it down. Pause the video and write it down afterwards. So we can write here y dash as, then we will continue. So our y dash is what? This 20, you will write this here. Right? 4 cos theta minus cos square. Now here also we can take cos theta common. Can you see here cos theta and cos square theta is there? So we can take cos theta common. So what will have 4 minus cos theta upon 2 plus cos theta whole square. Yeah, this is our right answer. Is that clear? Now let's see what we have to find. Now there is no need to get the interval because only increasing we have to find. We are not concerned with whether in which interval it is decreasing or in which interval, nothing, because they have already given the interval. They have already given the interval. We have to prove it. We have to just prove it. So 0 to pi by 2 will be increasing. But how will prove it? We have got y dash. What is the condition for increasing function? Just see here, increasing function. F dash x should be greater than equal to 0. F dash x should be greater than equal to 0. That means y dash should be greater than equal to 0 in which 0 to pi by 2. Now it is a closed interval because 0 and pi by 2 will be included. Yeah, 0 and pi by 2 will be included. Now you will see the value of cos theta from 0 to pi by 2. Cos 0 got 1 and cos pi by 2 is 0. So the value of cos theta will vary from what? It will be greater than or equal to 0 and less than or equal to 1. In this domain, value of cos theta will range from 0 to 1 in this particular domain. Is that clear? So value of cos theta is greater than or equal to 0 and less than or equal to 1 in this domain. So this cos theta, value of cos theta will be 0 to 1, which is what? Positive value. So it will be what? Positive in the denominator, you can write y dash. Cos theta will be positive. You can see 4 minus cos theta. Again, cos theta will range from 0 to 1. Value will be either 0 or 1 or in between. Now if you subtract 4 minus any value from 0 to 1, what it will be? Positive value. So we get positive here. Then divide it by 2 plus cos theta. 2 plus cos theta again. 2 is positive. Cos theta between 0 to 1, we have already put that in as a positive value. So positive plus positive whole square where? Otherwise also it's a square value, so it will always be positive. What you are getting? This is a positive value. If it is positive, that means what? You can say f dash x is greater than or equal to 0. Why we have taken equal to 0? It's a positive value. Why? Because at times when cos theta is equal to 1, pi by 2, the value can be gone. It can be 0 also. Value of here, when it will be cos of theta with pi by 2, so cos 90 will be 0. 0 multiplied by any term will be what? 0, so f dash x can be 0 also. Where it can be 0? At pi by 2. Pi by 2 is included. Here, is that clear? Yes, unmute yourself and let me know if it is clear or not. And then we'll move to the another question, which is an important question. Unmute yourself and let me know. Is it clear?
Yes. All clear, ma'am.
Is it clear? I can't hear.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am, clear.
Okay, now come to the next one. Come to the next question. By 2 determine the interval in which the function f x is equal to sin x minus x, f x is equal to sin x minus cos x is increasing or decreasing the interval 0 to the interval 0 to 5. Now, is it clear? Now what we are having, we have to determine the intervals in which the function sin x minus cos x is increasing or decreasing. Now, yeah, interval is what given in this particular interval. In the interval 0 to 2 pi, if you have seen sin function or cos function, what is sin function? 0 to 2 pi is 0 is 0. This is what? Pi by 2 pi and this will be 2 pi. From here to here, can you see the value of sin is changing? It is increasing and increasing and increasing. It is changing. Here from here to here, it is increasing and from here to here, increasing and again increasing. So that's why from 0 to 2 pi you have to find. Means the interval is 0 to 2 pi. In this particular interval also you will find somewhere the function is increasing, somewhere the function is. So the same process we will follow. Find f dash x. If your f x is this, for f dash x to be equal to what? Be what? Cos x, differentiation of sin x cos x, minus cos x to be the sin x. This will be your differentiation. Is that clear? Now, putting f dash x as 0, what we will get? Cos x equal to minus sin x. Or minus sin x is equal to minus cos x. Or you can say tan x is equal to minus. Take cos x down. Sin x upon cos x is equal to minus 1. So you can write tan x is equal to tan of minus 9, what is 1? Value of 1. When the value of 10 is 1, minus 10. Pi by 4. So this is here, this here. This here, we have what we have done. First of all, differentiate the function. Differentiation of sin x will be cos x directly. Then minus sin. Cos x differentiation will be minus sin x. Minus into minus into plus sin x. Yeah? Then, can we write this way? Cos x. Sin x is equal to, if we put this as 0, we put cos x plus sin x equal to 0. Doesn't it imply that sin x is equal to minus cos x? Or then you can divide between cos x here. So we have sin x by cos x is equal to 10 x is equal to 1. This much clear, 10 x is equal to minus 1. When 10 x is equal to minus 1, what is the value? Do you remember class 11? The general solution of tan theta, if tan x is equal to tan theta, what is the general solution? Or tan a is equal to tan b. So we are having tan x is equal to minus 1, minus 1 is equal to minus 1, then by that point that can be written as tan of x is equal to tan of minus 5 by 4. This much clear? Tan of minus tan theta is what? Tan of minus theta. Do you remember this thing? Sine of minus theta is what? Minus sine theta. Tan of minus theta is what? Minus 10 theta. So, we can write minus 10 theta as tan of minus theta. So, this is your thing. Now, what is the general solution for 10 theta? For general solution, if you don't remember, again, getting 10 a is equal to 10 b, you are having. So, what you can write? A is equal to n pi plus b. This is your general solution. Remember, it's okay if you don't remember, keep this thing in mind. Please remember the things which we have done in 11th or any other classes also. Maths is not a subject where everything will be revised in the same topic. Yeah? So if 10 is equal to 10 b, that means what a is equal to n pi plus b. So here what we are having? 10 x is equal to n minus 1. So x is equal to what? N pi plus When we write this way, A, this A is equal to what? This X, here, B is what? Minus 24, so N pi as it is plus minus 24, here, so it will be what? X is equal to N pi minus pi by, here, this much is clear. Now let's see, we have got this values of X. From here we will get the value because we want the intervals. We have to find the intervals where the function is increasing, where it is decreasing. So what we have taken X is equal to N pi minus pi. Now what is N? N is any integer value. Any integer value, so N can take N is equal to 0, it can be plus minus 1, it can be plus minus 2, it can be plus minus 3 and so on. Yeah, so we can take, put the values and get the values of X. Which? We get so many values of X. Now we will not be needing so many values. We need the values which are lying between 0 to 2 pi only. Clear? Now just see the visible. When we are putting N is equal to 0, the first thing, N is equal to 0. N is equal to 0, if you are putting here, you get X is equal to what? Minus pi by 4. Isn't it? X is equal to what? 0 into pi is 0 minus pi by 4. Now just see. Is this value valid for us? X is equal to minus pi by 4. We need the critical points. Now there are different methods to get the critical points. Here there is a different method to get the critical points. We need the values of X. Earlier also we have done this only. By putting f dash x is equal to 0, get the critical points. Here also we are doing the same thing. Now is this value valid? Because we are having the range from 0 to 2 pi. 0 to 2 pi is what? If you draw the line, this is what 0 to. We are taking the angle from this side. Now minus pi by 4 will be what? Here the angle. Clear? So this value is not valid. Why it is not valid? Because we need all positive values as well as the values which are lying from 0 to 2 pi, not other values. Clear? So this value, we will reject this value. Now the same, n is equal to 1. When n is equal to 1, we will have x is equal to what? X is equal to pi minus pi by 4, this will be equal to 4 pi minus pi, 3 pi by. Now is it valid? Yes, it is valid. It is 9, 3 pi by 4 is lying between 0 to 2 pi. So what value we have got? Let's see, I am rubbing this. What intervals we are getting? I have to write that. So this we have rejected minus pi by 4, what x can be equal to 3 pi by 4. Yeah, this is our first value. Now put x is equal to, n is equal to minus 1. Minus will never work. And also I am showing why minus will never work. When n is equal to minus 1, x will be equal to what? Minus 1 into pi minus pi minus pi. Will be again what? Minus 4 pi minus pi minus pi pi. Again it is what? A negative value. R. Interval is what? 0 to 2 pi minus sign will not come. Clear? So again this value will be invalid. Next value, n is equal to 2. N is equal to 2 if you will put. Let's see. When you will put n is equal to 2, what value you will get? N is equal to 2 implies x is equal to 2 pi minus pi by 4. That is equal to 4 to the 8 pi minus 5, that is 7 pi by. Now we will not take negative values, minus 2 will not take because we have seen that negative values, all the values will become negative. Values of x will be negative. Not inside this thing. Into it. Yeah? So we have got 7 pi by 4, yes it is also 9 between 0 to 2 pi, 7 pi by 4 is 9 between 0 to 2 pi. Here then n is equal to 3, gives you what? Implies x is equal to 3 pi minus pi by 4. This gives you what? 4 things are 12 pi minus pi, 11 pi by. Now just see 4, these are 2 points only. So it is more than 2 pi. This 11 pi by 4 is what? Greater than 2 pi. So again we will not take this value. Because we can take the value split. So the values of x will be what? What values of x we are getting? 0. Then 3 pi by 4, this is our number 9. Then 7 pi by 4, and then these are our intervals. Now here we will not take minus infinity plus infinity. We have been given the integrals. Here, so don't take this and value of specifically value of sine cos will not range from minus theta to minus sine minus infinity to plus infinity. Here, keep the integrals in mind that for the polynomial function we are talking about. Here, so we got these values. Now we will take the integrals and find out increasing or decreasing. Now we'll find the function whether it is increasing or decreasing. Clear? Now, same way we make what? Table intervals, then sign of f'x. What was our f'x? Your f'x was, if you don't remember, it was cos x plus sin x. Your f'x was what? Cos x plus sin x. Sin of f'x is nature of function. Now what we have to find, increasing or decreasing, not strictly increasing and strictly decreasing. Yeah? So intervals will be what? 0 to pi by 4, then pi by 4 to 7 pi by 4, these can be included, and then 7 pi by 4. Yeah? Now, whenever you are having an increasing function, or why we have taken 0 and pi by 4, we can take or not, that we will see. Just now I have taken, we will see what we are having. The condition is f dash x should be greater than or equal to 0 for increasing, and f dash x should be less than or equal to 0 for decreasing. Yeah. Now, in 0 to pi by 4, the function is what? Your f dash x is what this? So, if 0 is included, if we are taking 0 is included, so check it at 0, cos 0, check if you are only cos 0 is 1, 1 plus sin 0 is 0, so this is what? Greater than 0, 1 plus 0 will be what? 1 plus 0 will be greater than 0. Now you take any value, pi by 4 also. Want to check, no? Check it in between also and at the end points also. Pi by 4 also, pi by 4. What? 135 degree, 90 plus 45. So we can write cos 135 degree plus sin 135 degree. You can write this way, you know? P by 4 is what? 135 only? Check it out. Clear? So 135 means what? You can write cos 90 plus 45. These all things we have done in your small class. Plus sin 90 plus 35. Yeah. So what is cos 90 plus theta? Cos 90 plus theta is what? Sin theta. But what is the value? What is the value? Do you remember? Just see here. First quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant, fourth quadrant. I told you how to remember last quadrant. Also cos 90 plus theta. In 90 minus 90 plus change. Change means cos to changing sign. Sin. 45 will come. Sine quadrant. But where it is sine? Cos 90 plus theta is sine in the second quadrant. Second quadrant cos is positive or negative? Negative. So we have what to be like? Minus sine quadrant. Plus sine 90 plus 45. All sine and cos. Do you remember this? All are positive here. Here only sine is positive and cos is positive. Here 10 is positive, here cos is positive. So cos 90 plus 45 will be minus sine. Sine 90 plus. For 35 is 45. Sin 90 plus 45 will be equal to what? Sin 90 plus theta again, second quadrant, sin is positive. Yeah, so sin 90 plus theta will be cos. Now you know the value of sin 45. Sin 45 is 1 by root 2, but sin is minus here, plus 1 by root 2. Now the value is what? 0. So at 135, the value is coming out to be what? 0. So this interval we have considered. Why we have taken this as the closed interval? Because we are including this value. After including this value, we are getting the value of f'x is 0. And the condition for increasing function is what? It can be greater than or equal to 0. At 0, what we are getting? Is greater than 0, 1 it was coming. And at 3 by 4, what it is coming? 0. So it is ranging from 1 to 0. Is it clear? The next one we will see. Next interval we will see in the same way. The sine of f dash x was what? positive, go to that p value. So it will be what? Increasing. This positive or zero also. Can be zero also sign of attached, it will be positive only. Na? Zero is also considered, so you will not write this way. Write positive only because zero is never considered as a negative. Yeah. Then next, 3 pi by 4, 7 pi by 4. Just think of 3 pi by 4. Just we have checked 3 pi by 4. At 3 pi by 4, the value of f'x is coming out to be 0. Now check it at 7 pi by 4. What is 7 pi by 4? Just see. 7 pi by 4 will be the degree 3, 1, 5. We'll check it will be 2 f'x will be equal to what? Cos of 3 1 5 plus sine of 3, 1, 5. This can be written as cos 270 plus 45. Can we write? The C 45 will add 5, 7, 8, 9, 11, 9. The clear? So cos 270 plus 45 plus sine 270 plus. The first portion of the slide, that's why I'm doing each and everything. Otherwise, you can do by yourself. This is on 11th class. So cos 270 plus theta. I told you 90 change. 180, no change. 270 change. So cos will change to sine 545. Now just see where it will lie. Cos 270 plus theta. This is what? 90, this is 180, this is 270. Then you have 270. So where it will lie? 270 plus theta. Theta will lie 270 plus theta. Theta will lie here. Fourth quadrant. Now in the fourth quadrant, what do you see? Cos is positive or negative? But you are having all sine and cos. Cos is what? Positive. Positive sine 45 plus sine 270 plus theta will be cos 45. Now, in the again we like the fourth quadrant. What is the fourth quadrant? Sine is not negative. We'll get here what? Negative. So again we get what? We get 0. And you can check any value in between. So your value is at 3 pi by 4. At 3 pi by 4 you are getting value. Here also you are getting 0. Now you can check in between also. Can check in between also. Now at 270, just check at 270. 270 is coming in between. This 3 pi by 4 and 7 pi by 4. So 3 pi by 2. 3 pi by 2 is what? 270 is coming in between. So cos 270 is what? You can say cos 270, you know the value of cos 270 and sine 270. We will check at 3 pi by 2. We are checking at 3 pi by 2 now. So sine 270 and cos 270. Don't remember, then also you can find this way cos 180 plus 90 sine 180 plus 90. So you can write and cos 180 plus theta is what? Change or change? Cos 90. Now in 180 plus theta, cos will be cos is what? Negative, so minus cos 90 plus sine will be sine 90, but the sine will be what? Not 90 plus 70 minus. Now, so you can see here it will be minus 1 plus 0, that is negative. Yeah, so either it is what? We have checked it, both the points, it is coming out to be 0. So that's why we have checked in between. So in between at 3 pi by 2, the value is coming out to be negative. So when it is coming out to be negative, we can say that it is a function. Then you check from 7 pi by 2 to 2 pi. Now you check it by yourself, when you will check, you will get what? From 7 pi by 4, p1 pi, 2 pi is 360, this interval. In this interval, what you will see? This interval, you will see that sine of sine x, or cos x plus sine x is positive. So it will be an increasing. Is it clear to you all? This was an important question. Is it clear to you all? Class